When the Oilers joined the National Hockey League in 1979, Semenko followed. He would play 450.
They do. Stan Jonathan in his second fight with Ron Jackson. Oh, Jonathan got some fast lefts in there. Started, then Peterson went in, and Fogelin is there, and McCrimmon is squared off. That's Hughes with McCrimmon, and Semenko and Jackson, as this thing has really erupted. Early in the hockey game, there was a lot of chippiness down there. And the referee, Wally Harris, tried to contain it. He did for a while, but it has exploded here. 11:50 left to play, third period, 4-2 Boston. And we're going to have penalties. Here's how it all started, up against the board. As Jonathan went at it, the linesman trying to separate O'Reilly and Semenko. Is going at it with Hughes. The referee is warning them both. And whether that'll break out remains to be seen. McCrimmon and Hughes going at it well apart from the others. Peterson is third man in, I would believe, and he'll be gone for the game. O'Reilly and Semenko probably will be gone for the game under the new rules. So we'll have a ton of penalty minutes here. Jackson and O'Reilly, Jackson and Jonathan were the initial combatants.
To Dave Lovely, to Gretzky. Gretzky inside. Oh! What are you going to do? Gretzky. That's a beauty. That's a beauty, Kim. I'm sorry. That's unbelievable. Let's watch this one now. And Lovely set them up pretty good, though. You got to admit, him and Lovely beats it a bunch. Uses the screen. Top corner. If you're going to shoot along the ice or top corner.
Three-minute mark when Mel Bridgman decisions Oiler defenseman Paul Coffey, and Edmonton forward Dave Semenko is ejected after referee Dave Newell ruled he left the bench to assist Coffey.
Calgary's a brilliant period of goaltending for Michelle Dion of Pittsburgh. Fight breaks out now. Fight breaks out at center. Both clubs empty the benches. Now we've got some problems here. Somebody started fighting. I think it was Unger and Pat Price started to go to it. Well, hopefully, cooler heads will prevail here. Gary Unger and Pat Price involved in a scrap at center ice. They've got a hold of Unger. Penguins trailing here 2-0. We'll hold it right here before we break. Well, Paul, I did not get an opportunity to see what happened exactly on the play. I was watching for the recap here of the shots. Did you see what happened?
I was looking away too, Mike, and Pat Price and Unger might have bumped as they were crossing to go to their locker rooms, and it's not really a bench clearing thing because they're going off the ice here. So
coming out 24 into the Ranger end at the right side. Ralston just unloaded it. Semenko's out for the first time. Score! It's a whole new line for Semenko. Came out with Ralston, a whole new line for the Oilers for the first time, and they ganged up in front.
And Ralston, the rookie, comes up with his seventh goal of the season. It is now a two-goal spread again. He He's a draft choice for the Edmonton Oilers. Has the shot. And a tip in up front by Ralston.
So just like that, the Oilers have their two-goal lead back again.
Kevin Lowe.
Rebound as DeLorme is covered up. Now Semenko and Williams are squaring off. Steps is between them. A whole lot of talking going on. Are they going to fight? The crowd wants them to. DeLorme is going to challenge Semenko. Well, give DeLorme full marks for challenging the big guy. DeLorme and Semenko. Give DeLorme full marks, I tell you that. He's really maybe overmatched here. There's another guy, though, that'll never back away from anybody, Ron DeLorme, and he's got his hands full with one of the toughest guys in the league.
Well, when you see something like that, Jim, I'm glad we're upstairs. That Semenko took some mean hits at DeLorme, and I think DeLorme's heading for the dressing room to get repairs, but when you're challenged, DeLorme took the challenge, and you have to give him marks for that because that's Semenko true. Is one of the toughest guys in the league, but I think Semenko wanted to go at Williams.
The game, the most controversial play of this hockey game as Gretzky gets a break. Watch closely now. He takes the shot. The puck drops free in front of Edwards. He's bowled over. The puck goes in the net.
Los Angeles zone. Here's Wells back to pick it up. We're going to have a penalty on the play. Now Hughes coming up with the puck, and now play is called. And a holding penalty coming up against Edmonton on the play. And it's going to be against Dave Semenko, number 27, a holding call. Here's a look at it, Rod Gilbert.
Well, this is what I was trying to describe earlier, that Edmonton will play aggressive against LA tonight. But Dave Semenko is probably their most aggressive player, and in this case, sort of tried to take the man into the board, and unfortunately for him, he had to reach for him, and he had to pull him down in order to make contact with him, and he's gone for two.
Too far. Here's Semenko knocking down Chartrand, but they rule that Chartrand was able to touch the puck, so icing is called against the Edmonton Oilers. There's Dave Semenko.
There were two big men there.
Here's Hunter behind the net trying to center it. Murphy checked him off the puck. Now Semenko ran into Jay Wells.
Pass into the King zone. Gretzky. Anderson saved by Lassard. Nice pass by Gretzky from the right wing corner. Semenko with it behind the net. He's up there. Semenko pass to Gretzky. Gretzky checked by Bonner. Gretzky tried to center it, poked away by Lassard. Larry Murphy in the corner. He is bumped hard by Semenko. Murphy moves it along the board. Semenko checks him behind the King net. Puck is loose. Larry Murphy gets it over to Dave Lewis, and I think we may get a penalty to Larry Murphy now. And now Anderson swings his stick at Larry Murphy. I'll tell you, I haven't seen so much chippy stick work in a long time.
And really, it's on the part of both clubs. You can't blame the Oilers any more or any less than the Kings because both clubs are very chippy right there. The tempers were flaring because Semenko is bumping everybody in a blue and gold jersey behind Mario Lassard. Larry Murphy is going to go.
Did he hit Semenko at the blue line? Wells really cracked Semenko. Now Lumley throws a check along the boards. And now Lumley trying to grab who? Bernie Nichols?
Well, I can't.
Out of our view right now. One of the Kings down on the ice. That's a dangerous place to be with those skate blades around. This happened moments after Wells knocked Semenko down and then Lumley took a run at one of the Kings.
The linemen on top of both players, the linesmen and the two players on the ice along the near boards to the left of Mario Lassard. No punches are being thrown and the linesmen have their work cut out for them as neither player wants to let go of their grasp. We still are not sure who it is for the Kings, but whoever it is, he's quite upset. It is Bernie Nichols.
So Lumley went after Bernie Nichols right after Wells cracked Semenko at the King line right in front of the King bench. And did he belt Semenko? They both went down, but Semenko took
in the penalty box, and a couple of other Kings are stepping.